Hey guys, welcome to Rev, your ultimate guide to choosing your next ride. For this week, this is what we have for you. It's the Jaguar F-Pace Prestige, and it's one of the most good-looking SUVs out there. This particular variant has a 2-liter turbo diesel engine that gives you 180 horsepower, putting out 430 newton meters of torque. Yes, this is a diesel. It's almost like Jaguar knew exactly what our traffic conditions were like and built this engine especially for us. And we'll talk about that engine a little bit later on. But first, let's talk about what we see on the outside. Like we said, it's one of the most attractive SUVs out there. It's very sporty. It's got these sporty bulges up front, nice slim headlights, big front grille, and functional cutouts here towards the front bumper. Over on the side, you'll see that it's rolling on some attractive 20-inch rims. It's got a sloping roof line that ends in a good-looking spoiler. And from the rear, you'll see the slim taillights that wrap almost all the way around to the rear fender. Now, when you view it from the rear, the F-Pace has a very sporty stance. That's because most of its design cues come from the F-Type sports car of Jaguar. Now, on the inside, it's a nice mix of sporty and elegant. Let's start off by discussing these beautiful seats. Nicely upholstered in off-white leather, very comfortable, nicely contoured. These are heated seats and are powered adjustable for the driver and the passenger as well. Now, there's a decent amount of bolstering, but they are a little bit on the roomy side. It's quite a simple layout, very elegant, like I said. Depending on the trim and variant that you can actually get this model with a full digital instrument cluster. This particular one comes with analog clocks. It has an analog speedometer and an analog tachometer with a valley in between that with a small digital screen that gives you quite a bit of information. Very useful stuff. This is the Luxtec door trim, some nice wood grain paneling that you'll find over here. You'll also find it here towards the center console surrounding the hallmark of Jaguar, the hockey puck style shifter. It's got an upgraded infotainment system which runs a lot faster, which has been a comment from other Jaguar owners. Quite comfortable and very roomy, actually. Speaking of room, there's a lot of space in the back. You've got room for 5 passengers, although the passenger in the middle will find it a little bit difficult to find a good position because of the large tunnel required by the transmission. Again, depending on the trim that you get, there are a couple of different variants. You can get the back seats with power reclinable functions, or you can also get a very large sunroof, which this particular model doesn't have. It's quite roomy in the back. You've got a lot of space in that boot for large luggage or whatever type of sporty outdoor equipment that you want to bring. If you want to give yourself a little bit more room, you can drop those seats and expand that space a whole lot. All right, we're putting the Jaguar F-Pace through its paces with a little bit of city driving. And one of the things that's worth mentioning first is the fact that the 2-liter turbo diesel engine is extremely quiet and nice and smooth, actually. When you start up the car, there's not the usual roughness that you associate with a diesel engine. It's very smooth, it's very quiet. The cabin doesn't get a lot of the engine vibration and noise that's coming from the engine bay from that 2-liter diesel engine. It's quite smooth, it's very nice. Inside the F-Pace, it really is quite nice indeed. It's a high-end car, and it does feel that way. Nicely appointed, there's lots of room on the inside. In fact, almost a little too much room, if you ask me. Here on the driver's side, the armrest on the door is quite a bit of a stretch away, so there's a lot of space in terms of the driver and passenger side capacity. The roof line is also quite low. It's quite a sporty design, but there's ample headroom whether you're in the front or in the back, and there's quite a bit of adjustability. As we mentioned earlier, seats are powered, lots of adjustability there, very easy to adjust. It's very nice that the steering wheel is also adjustable by powered control. The trademark hockey puck shifter system of Jaguar. It takes a little bit of getting used to. I will admit this is the first time I've driven a car with that type of setup. It's quite nice. It's nice and different, but very easy to use and very easy to figure out, quite easy to get used to. Steering feel is a good strong point of the car. The car handles very well. It's a very sort of, the car leans on the sporty side of things, and the handling is quite nice. Suspension is on the firm side, not uncomfortable at all, very nice actually. But you do know that the car is sort of optimized for a bit more spirited driving. It can handle a little bit of spirited driving, so the suspension feel is quite firm. The one thing that I will comment on with the way the powertrain is set up is there is a little bit of perceptible lag. There's no two ways about it. You do feel it, and you have to be a little bit conscious of your inputs as far as throttle is concerned. If you drive it very smoothly, you will get a nice smooth ride out of it. But if you if you're a little heavy-footed, it does tend to feel a little jerky. There's a slight lag, and then the power comes on. So you have to be aware of the way that power is delivered, so that you avoid the jerkiness and give yourself a bit more of a smooth ride. What it does say to me, though, is there's a healthy amount of torque in the engine. It's a 2-liter turbo-powered diesel engine, 180 horsepower. You know, it's not going to blow your socks off, but there's a healthy amount of torque there. So there is a bit of rocking if you're not smooth with your inputs on the throttle. There are some nice creature comforts in here. Obviously, there are a lot of driving aids, proximity sensors, forward collision warnings, cruise control, the now almost standard on cars of this level, parking aids, which will help you to park the car, which are all very nice and really are something to be expected. The car comes kitted in different ways, or it comes specced in different ways. This particular version that we're driving does not have the digital instrumentation. It's got a mix. It's got two analog clocks, your speedometer and your tachometer, with a valley in between that gives you digital information. Now, when you're driving it in automatic, you can opt to make manual shifts at any point via these paddles that are on the steering wheel. It's quite nice to maneuver, actually. It handles very well. There's not a lot of overhang on the way the car has been set up. The wheels are well towards the corners. And the car handles quite well, and it's quite easy to maneuver. We're rolling through some pretty smooth city streets, and the suspension does feel quite nice. It's, like I said, on the sporty side of things, a little bit firm. We haven't hit any particularly bad roads, but we are rolling on slightly larger rims. I believe these are 20-inch rims. So it does add a little bit of harshness to the ride. Again, it's really your choice how you decide to inspect the car when you buy it. All right, in terms of visibility, quite good out the front. There's a slight bulge on the hood. But it's nothing to be concerned about. Visibility out of the side is also very good. You do give away a little bit of visibility out the rear window because of the sporty lines of the car. It's quite a small rear window. The view is adequate, but it's on the small side of things. Okay, now you do get the ability to control some of the car's functions through the buttons that have been integrated into the steering wheel. You've got the menu button here, which lets you toggle through the various functions, driver assistance, adjust your collision avoidance settings. You've also got collision avoidance. You can adjust your cross traffic detection. You can go into vehicle information. You can go into your vehicle settings and make all the adjustments you want via these sets of buttons here. And it's very easy to do even while on the fly, even while you're rolling. The Jaguar F-Pace features a lot of comforts and conveniences, such as the advanced parking package, which of course assists you when you park. You've got a 360-degree view. You've got a bird's eye view right here. You can also have a view from either side of the vehicle. You can have a view from the rear. And once the vehicle is moving, you can also get a view from the front-facing camera. We've also got a hands-free powered tailgate system and a tire pressure monitoring system. Now, these are all great features, which you should really expect in a car of this class.